what I need to do now is to change into the LFS packages. No, I won't. I'll stay here, actually. So one thing about the Linux kernel is that it won't build with the current version of Binutils. I had to build the new Binutils from Linux from scratch 6.3, and then use that Binutils to build the kernel. It doesn't complete the build. It builds the kernel right up to the end and then it fails. So it's probably a linking part that it fails at. So rather than waste time showing you that, I'm just going to start by building Binutils straight away and then go on to building the kernel. So let's extract this here. Now, where did I get this from? Was this the tools part? I think I copied the instructions from it, not pass 2. Pass 1. GCC. Tools configure. Yep. That looks like what I copied. So it looks like I adapted these instructions. They're not identical, but I use this configuration here. So another unfortunate thing is these packages are newer, therefore they're bigger because there's more in them. So everything's going to take a little bit longer until we get onto the Pentium 4. Like I say, then it'll be a lot faster. Okay, so that's extracted, so let's change into that. We'll start by, let's just see where I am, so I'm in Mount LFS. Right, what I've got to do is decide where I'm going to store the executables that I create here, so I think I'll store it in this place here, but I'll have to give it a subdirectory name. So let's create the build directory first. And copy this, and so the prefix, I'm going to put it into mntlfs, then our work directory, and then I'll call it just binutils, I think. Yeah, that'll do. And then I'll just add in these two here, because don't need to have an internationalization at all. Right, so what I might do actually is take note of how long this takes to compile and compare it when we come to build Binutils pass 1 on the new machine. That'd be interesting because it's going to be virtually the same. It won't be identical because I'm going to try and build this with a static flag. But it'll give a good idea of the order, the magnitude of difference. Yeah, this part's certainly taking a lot longer than the previous version of Binutils. Okay, I've just looked at top on another terminal and it's actually running three sed commands in parallel. So that's why it's so slow, because there's obviously only one core and a Pentium 233 MMX. Okay, that's done. So how I'm going to make this is with make LD flags equals static. And I think that will build as a static binary. Oh, I did note down this took 3.5 minutes on the Pentium 4, so it's likely to take half an hour or so. As I say, I'm sure it looked like the Pentium 4 was roughly 10 times faster than this machine. So we'll come back in about half an hour or so then. Okay, so that did take actually virtually 30 minutes. So what I need to do now is to run make install. So hopefully it's installing under this directory. Yes, it is. Okay, so now if I run ld minus minus version, you can see we're using version 2.14, which is the binutils that was built for LFS5. What I'm going to do now is to change the path, so export path equals, and then I'm going to put in the path of the binutils we just created. So let's just binutils/bin:, and then add in the current path because we still need access to all our other programs. And if I now rerun ld version, you can see that it's changed to 2.17, so it's using the new version of ld. And there it is there. If I do file ld, oh, it has actually dynamically linked it, not statically linked it. But never mind, it looks like it's working anyway because it reports the version number.